So this is the just now the separation of a mixture present in the inks. The simple dye ink of the ballpoint you are using, it is having the different components, and here it is the mixture of two colors, that is red and blue, and maybe there is the mixture of more than two colors, and this to separate all these three or two or more than two colors, we will be using the technique that is called the paper chromatography. So just first have a look on this video, and then I will discuss along with the experiment and how can you do at the laboratory.
Separation of components from a mixture of red and blue inks by paper chromatography. Chromatography is one of the most important separation techniques and is extensively used to separate mixtures and their components. It was first employed by the Russian scientist Mikhail Svet. In the paper chromatographic technique, the mixture of substances is applied onto a Wattmann filter paper strip in what is called the stationary phase. A pure solvent or a mixture of solvents is allowed to move slowly over the stationary phase. This moving phase is called mobile phase. When a mobile phase is moved over the mixture on the stationary phase, the components of the mixture gradually are separated from one another. Our aim here is to separate the components from a mixture of red and blue inks by paper chromatography. Materials required: chromatographic chamber with lid, mixture of red and blue inks, isopropyl alcohol water mixture, Wattmann filter paper strip, fine capillary tube, thread, scale, and a pencil. Procedure: take a Wattmann filter paper strip and draw a line with a pencil above 2 cm from one end. Draw another line lengthwise from the center of the paper. Name the point at which the two lines intersect as P. Take the mixture of red and blue inks using a capillary tube. Put a drop of mixture of red and blue inks at the point P. Allow it to dry in open air. Put another drop on the same spot and dry again so that the spot is rich with the mixture. Take a piece of thread and tie the filter paper to it. Suspend the filter paper vertically in the chromatographic chamber containing solvent, which is a mixture of isopropyl alcohol and distilled water. Make sure that the pencil remains about 1 cm above the solvent level. Keep the chamber undisturbed for some time. Notice the rising solvent along with the red and blue inks. After the solvent has risen, you will notice two different spots of blue and red colors on the filter paper. Take the filter paper out of the chamber and mark the distance that the solvent has risen on the paper with a pencil. This is called the solvent front. Dry the filter paper and put pencil marks on the center of the red and blue ink spots. Measure the distance of the two spots from the original line and the distance of the solvent from the original line. Calculate the RF values of red and blue inks by using the formula: RF is equal to distance traveled by the component from the original line divided by distance traveled by the solvent from the original line. Precautions: always make use of a fine capillary tube. Keep the chamber undisturbed and covered during the experiment. The spot should be rich with the mixture.
So this is about the experiment. Now sharing with your assignment. So this is the, actually this is the same we have already discussed, and now this is what it has been explained in the video, and this is separation of different chemical compounds are the mixture of ink using paper chromatography. As you know, the procedure which has been explained over here. So let's first have a look. How we are going to measure the distance traveled by each of the component. And here, when you put a spot over here, and then it is going to be separated into the three components. So the first one is the A, B, and the C. So you just take the scale and measure the distance, the distance, total distance traveled by the solvent. Actually, this is the separation between two phases. One we call the mobile phase. Mobile phase is the phase which is going to move. That's why this is called the mobile phase. And here the mobile phase is your solvent. In solvent, we are using a water and the ethanol or any of the organic solvent. And stationary phase is just the filter paper, because this is not going to move. It will remain stationary. That's why this phase is called the stationary phase. So paper chromatography is actually the separation of the components in the two phases. One is the mobile phase and other one is the stationary phase. So mobile phase is going to be carrying out all the different components present in the ink. And then you will get the first spot, second spot, and the third spot over here. You may find there is this ink is actually the composition of the three different colors. And how can we calculate the ratio between these three different components along with the solvent front? Solvent front mean the solvent will be moving from this point to the going upward, carrying out these three different components. And then with the separation of these component, whatever is the distance traveled by the solvent alone, that is called the solvent front. And here it is indicated as 4.7 centimeter. And the first one is the A is travel the distance from this baseline to this point. And this is the point, let's suppose it is 0.7 centimeter. And divided by this total distance traveled by the solvent alone, this will be 4.7, and the ratio will be 0.15. And the second one will be the B. It is going to travel 4.1 and divided by again 4.7, and this will be 0.87. And then the C will be 1.8 centimeter, again divided by the 4.7, and the ratio will be 0.38. And I think it is mistakenly written over here. This is the C and this is the B, because the small distance is covered by the A, 0.7. Then 1.8 is the B, and 4.1 will be C. So this will be C and this will be B. So this is actually with this technique. Now you have separated these three component present in the ink, and that this is called the separation of the three components present in ink mixture. And this is the calculated value. This is going to show you which point is appearing first and which is appearing at the last one. So if you have a look, the first ratio is 0.15 is small. That means the first point is covered over here is the A, and then it will be the B, and then it will be a C. So actually this ratio will give you the idea which component present in the ink mixture is going to be separated first and which is going to be separated at the last. So here, when you do the experiment in the lab, you can, of course, you can measure the distance traveled by each and the solvent front, and you can calculate this ratio between the component and the solvent. And this will be reduced when you perform the experiment in the lab. And here are a few questions about the exercise over this experiment. How many colors separated from the given ink mixture? It depends how many colors are there. And in the video, you have seen two colors, and here these are the three. And you can write depending on what type of the ink mixture you are going to use. So second is what serves as a solvent for the ink. And here in this case, we are using the solvent. It is the ratio of water and ethanol with 1:1 ratio. Let's suppose if 5 ml is the water and 5 ml is the ethanol, that's why it is called the 1:1 ratio. And this is the solvent we are using. And this is also called the mobile phase because the moving phase will be the mobile phase. And here solvent is acting as the mobile phase. As the solvent traveled up the paper, which color of the ink appear first? Of course, which is having the small RF value that is going to appear first. This is the answer of this question. So list the colors in order from the top to bottom, which separated from the black ink. And this you can easily identify from, you can just write what color are you going to visualize over here from C, then B, and then A. In milliliter, how did far the solvent travel? And in this case, it is 4.7. That is the traveling of the solvent from this baseline to here. That is called the solvent front. And 4.7 centimeter is the the distance traveled by the solvent. So from your results, what can you conclude is true about the ink mixture? And here you can define over here, this is a mixture of combination of three different colors, maybe the red, blue, and black. So why did the ink separate? And this is the very valid question. Why the mixture is having three different components? Because these are the three different colors, and each color having the different mobility along with the solvent. That's why this is going to be separated differently, not in a mixture, depending on their mobility along the solvent. So jiski ye mobility aapke paas ye iski kam hai ye first aapke paas hoga, then it is a more mobility, then it is moving further, and this C component is having more mobility, then it is again moving further apart from the baseline. So it depends on the mobility as well as the interaction of the components present in the ink with the solvent. Why did the ink separate? Due to the different mobility with the solvent, and different mobility in the mobile phase. Why did some inks move a greater distance? Again, these three, actually the question are three different, but the answer is the same, because each ink has its own mobility with the solvents. That's why their distance travel would be the different, and more distance is travel, which is having the more mobility along with the solvent. So this is all about your different experiments about the mixture, separation of the mixture out of the separation of the component out of different mixtures. So with this one, I'm going to